As regards the Notre Dame fire, now experts and authorities will be looking at the structure and trying to assess the residual stability and capacity of this structure. That will be a very complex task that will take some time. So first of all, we need to look at the fire event itself and understanding where the fire occurred and how it spread and what type of heat was generated, what was the temperature environment that was generated. So it seems as of now that the fire remained mostly contained in the roof structure, in the wooden roof structure, where most of the fuel was present as well as the combustible material, and that there was not that much burning at the ground level that would have heated particularly the stone structure. So the cathedral was mostly made of stone, which is an incombustible material, but is still challenged by heat. If there is significant heating, the stone can crack, it can be damaged, and it can need repair. But given the huge amount of stone, the huge mass, it's possible that the damage would have been limited, but this needs to be assessed. So fire generates heat that damages the material, and also that leads to thermal expansion and movements in the structure. So we also need to look at how this structure might have moved, both during the heating and during the cooling, because when the fire brigades are using cold water to extinguish the fire, that might create a thermal shock on the materials, the stones, that can also lead to cracking and to thermal movements. There might also be movements on the supports, as well as damage from debris. And I'm thinking, of course, of this spire that collapsed. So it collapsed by itself, could have damaged part of the structure. So assessing the residual stability and assessment will require assessing the fire severity, the thermal environment, the heat that was generated, as well as the damage to the materials and the movements of the structure under this heat.